joining us for another installment of Live at Recreate here at Recreate Arts Initiative in downtown Lebanon. Tonight we are featuring Terry Gayhart, who comes here to us tonight from Jonestown, Pennsylvania. Welcome back. What we're going to do, as usual, is we're going to have a short 30-minute set of music, a little interview, and then another short set of music. So, that sounds good to you? Let's get started. Without further ado, Terry Gayhart.
Thanks, Hez. What you'll be hearing are little tone poems that I create. And basically I play for as long as I can think of things to say with my guitar and tell a little story.
Thank you. Never use consuming as a religion. Thank you. Thank you.
Of Live at Recreate. Now is the time in our program when we sit down with our performer. With us tonight, Terry Gayhart. He's from Jonestown, right up the road. So, Terry.
Yes.
Have you lived in the area for a very long time?
Yes. We moved up here, what was it, over 20 years ago? Something like that. Yeah. And I work out at Fort Indian Town Gap on helicopter simulators.
Fascinating. Pretty cool.
Yeah, we chose Jonestown because we had a small girl that we wanted sidewalks and a safe place for her to live.
Yeah. Seems appropriate. Very nice little town out there. Country.
Yes.
Room to run.
Exactly.
Excellent. All right. Well, you may have seen Terry around if you're from the area. He's most often plays with his band Shift 7. Is that correct?
That's
and can you tell us a little bit about Shift 7?
Well, it's just kind of a project band. We play original music, and we have for years and years. I met Keith Myers at a place called Wolfer Magoo's I don't know if anybody remembers that place.
Infamous. We got some people infamous.
So they used to have an open mic, and you know, Jeff Gaines and stuff used to show up there. And,
wow.
And I met Keith there, and we hit it off and just started writing music and playing. We have ever since. So I always have, you know, always have Shift 7, but I've played in lots of cover bands over the years at the same time.
You know. So would you describe your solo performances as in the same vein as Shift 7?
Well, I do play some. Well, it's a rock band, absolutely. Right. You know, loud rock band. We like it. But the solo thing is really new to me.
Yes.
Because I've never really thought I could do it well. And not that I've proved I have yet, but
I think you have.
I started playing. I bought a looper, which I think every guitar player should have. Which people that don't know, a looper, you press the button, it records what you do. You press the button, and it repeats it. Mm-hmm. And that's how I create my little tone poems. Nice. And it started out
tone poems. Let's talk about that. And a lot of your solo work is improvised.
Yeah.
And you call them tone poems.
Yeah, it's basically, you know, it has a repeating pattern because of the looper. Mm-hmm. But I tried. I basically just try to ring as much. Well, I try to tell a story with the guitar, and try to, you know, put emotional parts into it. You know, whatever I can come up with, until I run dry, and then that's the end of the song.
Are you imagining a story unfolding in your head, or is it just more like an emotional journey?
Yeah, well, I don't know if you can tell a story with emotions. You know, without, you know, I'm not picturing anything. But
it's
like, you know, I need to flow into this type of feel, or, you know, that type of thing. So you're kind of telling a story, but there's no words, and there's no real visual to it.
Subject matter, really.
Yeah, nice. I started doing that. Well, my mother, she's in Kentucky, and I don't get to see her very often. And so I call her up almost every day. And sometime back, she asked me to play her a song. So I'm sitting there with my guitar anyway, so I play her a song. So now every time I call, I have to play her three songs.
Nice.
so that it's like, so you do this almost every day.
Uh-huh.
And it gets real a lot easier improvising.
Sure.
That's once I got to a certain point, my wife said, well, you should record some of this. So I recorded some, and I thought it sounded okay, and I thought I might be able to do a solo thing with it.
Yeah, well, I think you're doing an awesome job. I love it. So, such great, just melodies, and I think you're succeeding, you know? The emotional journey is happening for me, if that makes sense.
Well, it's nice to have a venue like this to experiment.
Happy to be here. It's great. So do you have any particular influences or inspiration that you draw upon when you're writing?
That's a tough one. I played, you know, I don't know if, I have, you know, musicians that I really love and stuff, but I can't play like them. I can only play like me, you know?
Sure.
I'm a terrible cover song player.
Well, and I think that's the way it should be. You know, you draw from others for inspiration, and then you take it to your place.
I take a cover song and not meaning to make it totally different.
That's good. That's what artists do, don't they? Create.
There we go. Create.
Recreate. Right. You know, yeah,
well, so when you're not playing, what do you listen to?
When I'm not,
so when you're not playing your own music. Kevin wants to know what you listen to.
Okay.
Kevin in Salt Lake City.
Well, but, you know, I grew up in the 70s, so any band that has that three-piece rock thing, that, you know, that's what I love the most. And so I listened to a lot of music like that. Of course, I like anything. A Weather Report, I absolutely love, but there's no way I could play any of that music or anything close to it, you know. But, you know, a lot of stuff I admire, and you know, it influences you when you listen to stuff. It just does, you know.
Yeah.
Especially if you play like I do, where, you know, it's all emotional. So.
Right. And, you know, the influences will seep in there when you don't even realize it.
Yeah.
You know, it's a sort of a subconscious thing.
Yeah, I have lots of people come up and say, oh, that sounds just like, you know. Mm-hmm. And it does. Not that I meant it to. You know?
I didn't mean it to do. Hey, yeah. It just comes out. Can't help it sometimes.
Exactly.
All right, well, what's up next for Terry and Shift 7? Are you playing out locally anytime soon?
Yeah, well, we play the second Friday of every month. We play at a place called Porch, the Porch Ooh. Pub. It's a five-star restaurant. It has a little pub in the bottom.
And that's in Myerstown, right?
In Myerstown. Well, it's past Myerstown on the road to Richland, I believe.
Millardsville.
Okay. Yeah, something
Millardsville.
Like. Yeah, it's a really great place and has, like, the best crab cakes in the world and all that stuff. You know?
It's a very sweet little spot.
Yeah.
And one of our, get all the best bands there.
Yeah, and Joe, the guy runs it, he only allows original music there.
Oh, good.
So
excellent.
You go see a band, you're going to hear original music. And it's all across the board. It's every kind of music. You know. And we were like the first band. I guess he considers us the house band. We were the first one that he asked if we could play all original. We said yes.
Oh, and you have a standing gig there.
Yeah, and we've been
every
playing.
Second Friday of the month.
Yeah.
Starting at?
9 o'clock.
9 p.m. 9 to 12.
Yeah. We've been playing over 10 years, every month.
Wow. That's amazing.
Yeah, it is amazing.
That's no small feat for a band around, you know, a local band to stick it out that long. It's impressive.
Yeah, you got to find people with venues that love music, like him. You know, he's a real deadhead. You know. Fishhead, whatever you want to call it.
Yes, oh, that's right. He does have all those. I work at the gallery, and he does some fish posters framed there before.
Yeah.
But I digress. Anyway, all right. Well, I think we've covered kind of our bases.
Okay.
Should we hear some more music, everybody?
Woo! All right. Please welcome once again Terry Gayhart.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Yeah.
Second Friday at the Porch in Myerstown.
Oh,
and
our drummer.
Oh!
A little bit. Hey! Bradley for sitting in tonight. Thanks, everybody. Have a great day. Bye.
Yay!
Thanks,
yay!
Practice for hours.
Yes, we did.
There you go.
Another great night here at Recreate. So thank you guys so much. We love this place. We love the music.
Yes,
so excited
a good
to see
time.
This.